So good morning, everybody. Today, yesterday, in fact, we talked about some fundamental aspect of sensors, which include some materials and then some fundamental properties of particularly ideal sensor requisite. What are the ideal sensor requisite? And then if you really want to achieve those ideal sensor requisite, what should be done? And we have seen that, like, we have, if we could synthesize material in nanostructure form, all those idealistic parameters can be achieved. This is what we have discussed yesterday. And then we started talking about promising sensing material. I told you yesterday, there are many promising materials available across the, in research field. And like these four materials are being widely used: carbon nanotube, organic conducting polymers, porphyrin with free base and metal substituted porphyrin, metal nanoparticles. And apart from these four materials, there are other materials as well, like metal organic framework, graphene, thalocyanine. Okay, but like we are focusing more on these four. And Very recently, we started working on MOF as well as graphene too in the research lab. Now, what I'm trying to tell you is, although there are good number of materials which are being explored for development of sensor, in spite of that, selectivity altogether remain an unresolved issue, and still it is challenging. Now, I told you yesterday what essentially the research scholars are doing in order to address selectivity issue. What they are doing, they are testing their sensor to various hazardous gases, like various analytes. And let us say, like, if they have got, if they get good response to one of those gas analyte, let us say, like, you have exposed your sensor or you have tested your sensor to four different gas analyte, and out of that, let us say for one you got good response around like 80%, and for others you got less than 10% or less than 5% response, then what essentially nowadays researchers are doing, they are plotting these responses in the form of histogram, and then they can compare there that this 80% is, those who are having, who got less than 5% or less than 10% response, these responses are negligible as compared to the 80%, like the for the gas analyte for which they got 80% or more than 80%. And as a result of that, this is how they are claiming selectivity. Truly speaking, as far as devices are concerned, as I told you yesterday, if you really want to address the selectivity issue, what you need to do is, you need to make sure that your material is going to have affinity towards only one gas analyte, and which is going to be very challenging. And that is why, although there are, as I mentioned yesterday, although there are huge number of papers coming every day in the area of sensor, but still you have enough scope to to inculcate novelty in your investigation. You can modify the material, you can have some dopant, you can have the combination of some material, composite, and as a result of that, you can think of enhancing those properties which we have discussed yesterday. Idealistic feature, like you can think of reaching those idealistic features. Now, whenever we are talking about material, we need to, let us say, like, if you are having four options in front of you, then how to screen those material? What should be strategy that we are going to discuss? Yesterday we started, but now we are going to continue the same. Let us start from carbon nanotube. Like, I will give you one example of carbon nanotube. Like in this presentation, we have discussed three materials: carbon nanotube, porphyrin, and organic conducting polymers. And I will tell you how to deal with this issue. Right. So first of all, whenever you are choosing one particular material, please try to understand all the fundamental issues about that. Like, what when what is carbon nanotube, when it was discovered, right? So carbon nanotube was discovered in the year 1991. It is not very old, it is very young. It has got unique material properties. It is nearly one-dimensional structure. As I told you yesterday, its length is around 5,000 to 6,000 nanometer, whereas the diameter would be few nanometer. So therefore, it is nearly one-dimensional structure. It has got single or multiple carbon nanotube. Yesterday, I told you this. This is a graphene sheet. Okay, basically, it's a graphene sheet rolled up. It is a rolled up graphene sheet. Now, depending on how we are rolling this graphene sheet, that will decide whether you are going to end up with semiconducting CNT, metallic CNT, or insulating CNT. Now, the problem is whenever you are synthesizing CNT, you are not going to, I mean, you cannot predict that what is, how the rolling is going to be happening during synthesis. But you can optimize the parameters and you can make it sure that you will be having, the dominant concentration of the desired CNT. It could be metallic, it could be semiconducting, or it could be metallic or semiconducting in particular. So this is the example of single wall carbon nanotube. This is example of multi-walled carbon nanotube. You can see there are different walls. This is inner wall and then next wall and this. So there can be multi-wall carbon nanotube. Now, whenever you are talking about the sensor, multi-wall carbon nanotubes are going to have limited scope because it has got certain disadvantages. So we are not going to discuss much about multi-wall carbon nanotube, but we are going to discuss single wall carbon nanotube. Now, what are the interesting properties? CNTs are extraordinarily strong. CNTs are extraordinarily strong. It is 100 times stronger than steel. You can see the CNT is like 100 times stronger than steel. But as far as weight is concerned, its weight is 1/6 of steel. Like same amount of CNT, if you could take, then it's as far as strength is concerned, it is 100 times stronger. But as far as weight is concerned, it is 1/6 of the weight is going to be only 1/6. CNTs, as I mentioned earlier, CNTs can be metallic like metals. It can be semiconducting like silicon, which is being used in semiconductor CNTs are being used in computer chips, right? Integrated circuits. As far as the surface area is concerned, since it is nanostructured material, it has got very, very huge surface area. If you take 4 gram of material, surface area 4 gram of CNT is similar to the surface area of football stadium. You can see, aap agar football stadium ka agar area aap dekhoge, so the area of the football stadium is equivalent to the area of only 4 gram of CNT. 4 gram of you just imagine 4 gram is going to be a minute dot. If you take the 4 gram of CNT and if you put it on your paper, any white paper, you will get only dot. Okay, but if you measure surface area is going to be equivalent to the one football stadium. You can imagine now how, like, whenever you are reducing any material down to nanoscale, how huge enhancement in surface area is going to take place. This is just an example of that. It has got very high electrical conductivity. That is also very, very important. It has got thermal conductivity, very high thermal conductivity as well. The most very interesting property of carbon nanotube is it has got ballistic conduction property. Now, ballistic conduction property means what? Like usually, whenever you take any wire, metallic wire, if you increase the length, resistance is going to be increases. Resistance of the material is going to be increases if you increase the length. It is directly proportional to resistance is going to be directly proportional to the length of the material. Whereas, as far as the carbon nanotube is concerned, even if length increases, its resistance remains constant. So this is very unique property of carbon nanotube, and which is going to be very, very useful for developing electronic devices. Now, the I mean, these properties are general properties. Now I'm going to consider the proper advantageous aspect, like अगर हमें कार्बन नैनो ट्यूब अगर यूज करना है हमारे रिसर्च में, तो आपको देखना पड़ेगा कि उसके एडवांटेजेस क्या है और डिसएडवांटेजेस क्या है, राइट? एंड देन यू सी वेदर दोज एडवांटेजेस एस्पेक्ट्स आर गोइंग टू बी गुड फॉर योर एप्लीकेशन, एंड वॉट एवर द इश्यूज आर देयर, वॉट एवर डिसएडवांटेजेस एस्पेक्ट आर देयर, वेदर यू विल बी एबल टू एड्रेस दोज इश्यूज. ओके, लेट अस सी. नाउ वी नो कार्बन नैनो ट्यूब इज बेसिकली ग्राफीन शीट. Carbon nanotube is basically graphene sheet rolled up. It is rolled up graphene sheet. So due to curvature nature, because since it is rolled up, outer surface is going to be curvature in nature. Now since the outer surface of CNT is curvature in nature, what happens? Their electrons are going to be distorted. Electrons are going to be distorted. As a result of that, outer surface is going to be very, very much active. So whenever CNT comes in contact with any gas analyte, it can easily do the exchange of electrons. You can easily take part in the exchange of either it will release electron or it will gain electron from the analyte. As a result of that, the properties of the CNTs can be easily modulated. This is what we are expecting, because what is happening, what we are expecting in sensor, like whenever that material comes in contact with any gas analyte, its properties should be modulated, and this is what it can be easily achieved. Okay, this is one of the advantages aspect. What is another advantages aspect? It has got very high aspect ratio, which may enable them to act as a molecular wire. So this is another important advantages aspect, that surface to volume ratio in CNTs is very, very high. It has also got excellent thermal, mechanical and electrical properties for harsh environment. And I told you earlier that it has got ballistic conduction. I mean, even if the length increases, resistance remains constant. This is something very, very important. So these are some of the advantages aspect of CNT which can be used. As a result of that, you can say that CNT is a very good material for sensor application. Okay, so these advantages aspects are going to play a very important role as far as sensor applications are concerned. Now, but it iska matlab aisa nahi hota ki inke koi disadvantage nahi hogi. CNT has some disadvantage as well. So you need to understand what are those disadvantages, right? So let us see. What are the disadvantages? It has got very poor recovery. Why poor recovery? Because we know CNT has got honeycomb structure. Ab dekhiye ye jo hai na, ye dekhiye, this has got honeycomb structure, right? Yeah, honeycomb structure hone se kya hoga? Whenever this CNT comes in contact with the gas analyte, those gas molecules are going to absorb on inner side of the wall, inner side of the, ye jo CNT na, iske inner side pe they are going to absorb. And as a result of that, jab recovery hum kahenge, because recovery ka matlab kya hoga? Ki whenever whatever gas molecules which are been absorbed, all those gas molecules you should be able to remove those gas molecules. But whereas yahan par honeycomb structure hone ki wajah se kya hoga, wo gas molecules wo honeycomb structure se andar jayenge and inner wall pe jaake baith jayenge. As a result of that, during recovery, you will not be able to remove all those gas molecules. And as a result of that, it will take more time to remove those. And some of the molecules are always going to be there. It means it will be like recovery time will be more and it will not perfectly recover. Okay, it will not perfectly recover. So this is one of the disadvantages. राइट, और आपको देखना पड़ेगा कि ये अगर डिसएडवांटेज है तो वेदर यू विल बी एबल टू एड्रेस दैट डिसएडवांटेज, दैट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. नेक्स्ट इज पुअर सेलेक्टिविटी. इट हैज गॉट पुअर सेलेक्टिविटी ड्यू टू लिमिटेड ट्रांसडक्शन मैकेनिज्म एम्प्लॉयड. व्हाट इज व्हाई? बिकॉज़ वी नो एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर कि कार्बन नैनोट्यूब इज रोल्ड शीट एंड बिकॉज़ ऑफ कर्वेचर इन नेचर क्या हो रहा है कि कार्बन नैनोट्यूब इज ऑलवेज एक्ट outer surface is always active, and as a result of that, when it comes in contact with any gas analyte, they are going to have the electron exchange. इसका मतलब ये होगा कि जो भी गैस आएगा उसके साथ में एफिनिटी कार्बन नेटवर्क बताएगा, उसके साथ में इलेक्ट्रॉन एक्सचेंज में पार्टिसिपेट करेगा. सो आई मीन इट विल बी पुअर सेलेक्टिव. आई मीन जो भी गैस एनालाइट होंगे सभी गैस एनालाइट को कार्बन नेटवर्क रिस्पॉन्स देगा, वो तो हमें नहीं चाहिए. बिकॉज आई टोल्ड यू लाइक यू नीड टू हैव अ मटेरियल विच विल बी हाईली सेलेक्टिव, तो वो तो बात बनेगी नहीं. इसका मतलब इसकी सेलेक्टिविटी बहुत पुअर है. हमें देखना है कि वेदर वी विल बी एबल टू एड्रेस दोज इश्यूज. थर्ड वन इज डर्थ ऑफ एफिशिएंट मेथोडोलॉजी फॉर इनकॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ CNTs इन सेंसर मैट्रिक्स. आप लोगों को मैंने पहले से बताया कि CNTs इज नैनो स्ट्रक्चर मटीरियल, लेंथ इज अराउंड 5 to 6 micrometer, हमारी थिकनेस है ह्यूमन हेयर की 10 to 15 nanometer और इसका लेंथ है 5 to 6 nanometer, micrometer. आप सोचिए कि ये कार्बन नेटवर्क कितना कितना इसका डिमेंशन कितना छोटा है, एंड डायमीटर इज ओनली कपल ऑफ नैनोमीटर. सो इट इज गोइंग टू बी अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग जॉब टू इनकॉर्पोरेट दिस काइंड ऑफ नैनो स्ट्रक्चर मटेरियल इन CNT मैट्रिक्स बिकॉज ऑफ नैनो स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, सो दीज आर 3 इंपॉर्टेंट डिसएडवांटेजेस और इश्यूज, and you need to understand that whether you will be able to address those issues. If you are able to address those issues, then only you should use this material for sensor application. Agar aap ye issues address nahi kar pao, so then you should not go for this material. Isliye jab bhi aap laboratory mein material select karte ho, to aapko dekhna padega ki uske advantages aspect kya hai, whether those advantages aspects are going to be good for my application. If yes, then okay, in first screen you can consider that material. But at the same time, you need to understand what are the issues, what are the disadvantages of that material. And आपको देखना पड़ेगा कि वो जो disadvantages हैं, उसको अगर आप address कर पाओ during synthesis or during its applicability application, then only you should use that material. Otherwise, you cannot. Okay. Now, since we have listed down 3 important issues or disadvantages, we need to understand what people are doing in order to address these issues, what the researchers are doing across the globe. So recovery, as far as recovery is concerned, recovery ke liye kya kar rahe log, they are exposing CNT to UV light for 2 to 3 hours or high temperature exposure for 15 to 20 minutes. UV light ko aap agar expose karoge aapka material aur high temperature ko expose karoge for 15-20 minutes and UV light for 2 to 3 hours, automatically those gas molecules jo inner side pe jo baithe hue hai, those gas molecules are going to be evaporated and you are going to have a perfect recovery. But the problem is this kind of way out is not going to be feasible for mobile application. Kyunki lab mein laboratory testing ke liye theek hai, but whenever you are talking about devices, okay, so for mobile application, this is not going to be useful. Now, as far as selectivity is concerned, there are many research scholars that are addressing what they are doing, they are decorating carbon nanotube by various metal nanoparticles. Jaise ki maan lo koi carbon nanotube hai, usko kya kar rahe? They are decorating with metal nanoparticle. Why? Because these metal nanoparticles, some of the metal nanoparticles has affinity towards a specific gases. क्योंकि सेलेक्टिविटी की बात हम कर रहे हैं, जैसे कि मान लो पैलेडियम है, पैलेडियम इज हैविंग एफिनिटी टुवर्ड्स हाइड्रोजन, गोल्ड हैज एफिनिटी टुवर्ड्स H2S, लाइक दैट. सो यू नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई दोज मेटल नैनो पार्टिकल व्हिच विल बी हैविंग एफिनिटी टुवर्ड्स सम ऑफ द गैस एनालाइट, एंड वो जो मेटल नैनो पार्टिकल्स है आप आपके CNT को डेकोरेट कर दीजिए. डेकोरेट कर दीजिए मतलब क्या होगा, उसके ऊपर बैठेंगे. As a result of that, you will be able to, वो जो selectivity का problem था, so selectively that metal nanoparticle decorated CNT will be responding to some of the specific analyte only. So you will be able to address this issue. But even if you address this issue, आपका जो binding site जो है वो तो open ही रहेंगे, क्योंकि आपने आप wrap up नहीं कर रहे CNT को, you are just decorating. तो जो gap रहेगा, गैप में से तो फिर से गैस एनालाइट अंदर जाके बैठ ही जाएगा. रिकवरी ही विल नॉट बी एबल टू एड्रेस रिकवरी प्रॉब्लम. सो सेलेक्टिविटी कैन बी एड्रेस, बस रिकवरी कैन नॉट बी address. I mean, recovery problem would be still challenging. So these are some of the way out the researchers are exploring across the globe. लेकिन जिसके कुछ problems हैं. So हमने देखा कि फिर क्या हम कर सकते हैं? Because ये problem अगर avoid करना है, ये problem को अगर address करना है, तो what should be our approach? So then we started thinking of our own approach. What should be the way out for this? So what we have decided to functionalize CNTs with by using non-covalent functionalization with different parameters, different materials, right? So what we are essentially we will be doing? Let us say, अगर आपका CNT है, okay? तो हम क्या कर रहे हैं? इसको CNT के ऊपर पूरा उसको wrap up कर रहे हैं, दूसरे अलग materials. तो wrap up करने से क्या होगा? ये जो ऊपर मतलब wrap up करना मतलब ऊपर से coating चढ़ा दे रहे, right? As a result of that, ये जो इसका जो recovery का problem था honeycomb structure के वजह से gas molecule अंदर जाके बैठ रहे थे, वो तो अभी होगा नहीं क्योंकि गैस एनालाइट तो डायरेक्टली ऊपर लेयर जो है उसी को कांटेक्ट करेगा, अंदर तो अंडरनीथ तो हमने कवर कर दिया उसको, राइट? सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द एडवांटेज. अनदर एडवांटेज इज दोज मटेरियल्स आर गोइंग टू बी द एनालाइट स्पेसिफिक. कुछ मटेरियल है जो सीओ को रिस्पॉन्ड करते, कुछ मटेरियल है जो एसटीएस को रिस्पॉन्स करते, कुछ मटेरियल है जो CO2 को रिस्पॉन्स करते. सो वी आर गोइंग टू हैव coating of that material on CNT. As a result of that, this particular issue like selectivity issues can be addressed and recovery issue can also be addressed. Now main jo problem hai ki ye jo nanostructure material hai usko kaise use kare, kaise handle kare, right? For that purpose we are using AC dielectrophoretic alignment of CNTs between microfabricated electrodes. एसी डाइलेक्ट्रोफोरिक अलाइनमेंट क्या है? जैसे कि आपको सीएनटी का सस्पेंशन बनाना है, उसका ड्रॉफ रखना है, एंड देन यू हैव टू अप्लाई द एसी वोल्टेज. एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दैट, ड्यू टू पोलैरिटी, आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू दैट डायग्राम, ऑटोमेटिकली योर सीएनटीज आर गोइंग टू बी अलाइन. आपको कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी, ऑटोमेटिकली सीएनटीज विल बी अलाइन अक्रॉस द गैप. दैट आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू, एंड एज एंड मोरओवर सिंस दे आर अलाइन, ऑल अलाइन, they are going to ensure well-defined pathway for charge carrier during signal transduction. This is also very, very important because aapke CNTs agar network type hai, right, like that. So kya hoga? There won't be jo current conduction hoga, wo because pathway jo hai clear nahi hoga, well-defined nahi hoga. As a result of that, lot of current you will be wasting and therefore it will affect adversely on the response time, particularly response time and load detection. Whereas if it is well aligned, obviously the response can time can further be enhanced and its sensitivity also can be enhanced. Therefore, we are going to ensure that it is going to be well defined and it will be well aligned between two electrodes. Okay, so this approach we are adopting in our laboratory. So these are conventional approaches. We have told you like what are the approaches. These are the issues, right? हमने क्या किया? Advantages देखे, disadvantages देखे, and then we out क्या है वो disadvantages address करने का वो देखा, and then we came to know that okay, these way out are not going to be good for us. So we try to come up with our own way out. We after doing several experiments on this particular issue, and as a result of that, we got success. And this is what we are doing since almost one decade. Okay, we are functionalizing CNTs with various material, which includes porphyrin, organic conducting polymers, and other material as well. So this was about carbon nanotubes. तो आपको भी समझ में आया कि जब भी कोई मटेरियल हम सेलेक्ट करते हैं तो आपको क्या करना है? आपको उसके सबसे पहले उसका बेसिक पढ़ना है, देन उसका एडवांटेजेस देखना है, देन उनके डिसएडवांटेजेस देखने हैं, एंड देन यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वेदर यू विल बी एबल टू एड्रेस दोस डिसएडवांटेजेस एस्पेक्ट. अगर आप एड्रेस कर पाओ देन only you should use that material. Otherwise, you should throw that material away and you should search for some other material. जैसे हमने organic, जैसे हमने CNT का देखा वैसे ही organic conducting polymer. Now, what is organic conducting polymer? It exhibit wonderful electrical, electronic, and magnetic and optical properties of metal or semiconductor. इसका मतलब क्या है कि this conducting polymer can be either metal or semiconductor. Of course, insulator with the कभी भी ले जा सकते. It can be synthesized by plenty of SI routes. There are n number of routes, very easy routes available for synthesis of organic conducting polymer. Conductivity can be modulated over 15 orders of magnitude. One of the advantages aspect of CNT is conductivity can be modulated over 15 order of magnitude. तो आप देखिए कितना कितना advantages है. It is applicable as conductometric, potentiometric and amperometric and as well as voltammetric transducer. मतलब ये and as a active layers of FET as well. I mean like in case of field effect transistor, we are using organic conducting polymer as active layer and of course in thin film form as well as in nanostructure form. Thin film has its own problem. Those problem can be identified, those problem can be addressed if you go for nanostructured material, right? So the organic conducting polymer are being used as active layers of field effect transistor. And as far as the sensor is concerned, it can use in conductometric center sensors, potentiometric sensors, and amperometric sensors and voltammetric sensors as well. Now these are some of the advantages. What are the disadvantages? It has got low electrochemical activity and it has got hysteresis as well. Now low electrochemical activity agar hai to iska matlab kya, aapko composite karna bahut zaruri hoga ya to uska form badalna bahut zaruri hoga. Usually when in bulk form it has got very low electrochemical activity. To agar hum isko nanostructure mein agar lekar jaye, if you can use nanostructured material or organic conducting polymer for sensor application, I'm sure it is going to provide you wonderful option. It has got hysteresis as well. Hysteresis ka matlab kya hai ki jaise ki maan lo yahan par humne shuru kiya, right? So in one cycle we like in forward direction we reach here, right? So whenever you will be going back in reverse direction, you should reach the same point. But it is not happening. It will reach somewhere else, right? So that kind of problem is always there, and which is always going to hamper the reproducibility and repeatability of the sensor. So these are some of the objectives, and you need to understand whether you will be able to address those objectives. So what I understood is by changing dopant, by having composite of organic conductive polymer with other material, these issues can easily be addressed, and there are many research scholars nowadays, they are using organic conducting polymers in different form, in thin film form, in nanostructure form, and coming up with various sensors, right? So jaise maine bataya aapko ki humne kya kiya abhi, pehle aapko CNT ke bare mein bataya, uske advantages, disadvantages, whatever disadvantage aspects are there, whether we will be able to address those. Address agar kar pao to hi hum is direction se ja sakte hain. Abhi humne dekha ki organic conducting polymer, there are many advantages, at the same time there are certain disadvantages as well. To hame dekhna hai ki ye jo advantages aspect hai, kya ye hamare sensor application ke liye kaam ka hoga, ye jo disadvantages aspect hai kya hum usko address kar payenge, या तो क्या हम इसको नजरअंदाज कर पाएंगे. सो ऑल दोस थिंग्स नीड टू बी यू नो क्रिटिकली एनालाइज एंड देन डिसीजन कैन बी टेकन. सो दिस इज अनदर मटेरियल व्हिच हैज गॉट मेनी एडवांटेजेस एस्पेक्ट एज कंपेयर टू डिसएडवांटेजेस एस्पेक्ट. एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर, ऑर्गेनिक कंडक्टिव पॉलीमर कंडक्टिविटी कैन बी मॉड्यूलेटेड right from insulator to the metal. So you can see you will have, this is polyaniline, is almost insulator. Polyaniline is almost insulator. But while synthesizing, if you can take proper care you can either reach in semiconductor region or in metallic region. Truly speaking, we are expecting all materials to reach semiconducting region. The reason for is we are working on sensors, right? For the sensor application, like there are very few critical criteria. One of those is surface to volume ratio, and second is going to be the conductivity. The conductivity of that material should reach, you know, in semiconductor region. And this is quite possible by changing the dopant. एक बात हुई. दूसरा ये कि अगर आप कार्बन नैनोट्यूब एंड कंडक्टिंग पॉलीमर का अगर कंपोजिट सोच रहे हो, हमने देखा ना सीएनटी का डिसएडवांटेज क्या है. सीएनटी का डिसएडवांटेज है कि वो रिकवरी का प्रॉब्लम है, राइट? उसका एफिनिटी सभी के साथ है, इसलिए हम क्या सोच रहे हैं, हम वी आर सर्चिंग फॉर मटेरियल विच कैन बी कोटेड ऑन कार्बन नैनोट्यूब, राइट? हमने देखा कि ऑर्गेनिक कंडक्टिंग पॉलीमर इज कैन बी अ गुड कैंडिडेट फॉर हैविंग यू नो सरफेस कोटिंग ऑन सिंगल वॉल कार्बन नैनोट्यूब, राइट? Now the problem is whenever you are using composite, whenever you are coating one material on another, you need to see whether they are going to have some sort of communication. क्योंकि एक के ऊपर एक दूसरा जर हम coat कर रहे हैं और दोनों में कोई communication नहीं हो रहा है, तो then there is no use, there is useless combination, right? What we observed, because this can be understood through the literature, right? So while going through literature, we observed that the ability of conducting polymer to maintain intimate contact within SWNT sidewall is due to bypass stacking. So kya hota hai, conducting polymer and CNTs, they are having a bypass stacking. Jab ye ek sath aate to bypass stacking hoti. As a result of that, uska jo upar wala surface jo hai, electron clouds are going to be highly delocalized, right? And jab delocalized hota hai, iska matlab jo hai, that structure is going to be wonderful for application, sensor application in particular. Moreover, since they are going to have a wonderful contact through bypass stacking, upper ke layer mein jo bhi changes aap karoge, the same changes are going to be, you will be able to transfer those changes in underneath, on underneath layer. This is what we are expecting, right? So these are some of the advantages aspect. ये उसी का फिगर है जो हाई डेंसिटी पाइपलाइन स्टैकिंग कैसे होता है, हाउ डीलोकलाइजेशन कैन बी अचीव. वी आल्सो ऑब्जर्व दैट बाय चेंजिंग सपोर्टिंग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, बिकॉज़ व्हेनेवर यू विल बी सिंथेसाइजिंग ऑर्गेनिक कंडक्टिंग पॉलीमर, यू नीड डिफरेंट इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स, ओके? वी कॉल इट एज ए डोपेंट, राइट? सो बाय चेंजिंग डोपेंट यू कैन नॉट ओनली मॉड्यूलेट सेंसिटिविटी, बट व्हाट वी ऑब्जर्व इज conducting polymer can change its affinity towards different gas and rate based on dopant as well. If you change the dopant, affinity of that particular material with the gas and the light is going to be modulated. Okay, this is what we observed. This is what we observed while doing experimentation. It means that this aspect is going to be very good for when if you are working on sensor. In fact, like whenever you are talking about the wrapping of material on SWNT, there can be two different options. One could be electrochemical functionalization, other could be drop casting. Now, as far as electrochemical functionalization is concerned, and if you are having SWNT and if you are coating SWNT by organic conductive polymer by using electrochemical functionalization, it is going to enhance sensitivity, selectivity, and response time. This is what we observe from various literature, that if you are using electrochemical functionalization, it will help us to enhance sensitivity, selectivity, and response time. What are other advantage of electrochemical polymerization? Relatively, it is low cost. I said low cost, relatively low cost, right? Site-specific non-covalent functionalization is also possible. Of course, it is going to be little costly, but site-specific non-covalent functionalization can be possible. सिंपल एंड हाई मैन्युफैक्चरेबिलिटी, बड़ा बड़ा आसान है एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग के लिए बड़ा truly speaking kafi throughput dene wala hai. It has got high throughput, ability to functionalize with various material. Alag alag material se aap CNT ko functionalize kar sakte ho. Ability to tailor the morphology, material and electrical properties. Aap dekhiye ki you will be able to, is morphology, material and electrical properties, whatever properties, not only electrical, like spectroscopic properties, spectroscopic, morphological, structural, on and electrical, all those properties can be easily modulated. And fabrication of high density NAM sensor array is possible. With this, you will be able to fabricate more number of NAM sensor array, and which is going to be one of the advantages aspect of CNT. After one minute, this link is going to be terminated. You are requested to rejoin by using the same link. Now, we talked about CNT and then organic conducting polymer. So we have seen what are the advantages of CNT, what are the disadvantages.